Indeed, Jan Shankar Prasad, you've sat in Army headquarters. You were Director General Infantry, and we've been talking about a national war memorial for a long time now. After Kargil, the war which India won against Pakistan, a lot was said that a war memorial will come. Why hasn't it come so far, sir?
Well, let me tell you, war memorial is not a place which is only for the armed forces. It is not a memorial which is belonging to the armed forces. It's a memorial that belongs to the nation.
Yes.
And let me tell you, you are talking about me as the Director General Infantry.
Yes.
Every regiment of the infantry today has a war memorial. You go to any regimental center, you will find a fantastic war memorial. Every single regiment, every single naval and air force establishment has a war memorial. Most cantonments have a war memorial. It's only in the national capital, which represents the nation, we do not have a war memorial. This war memorial somehow is seen by people and by the government perhaps as a memorial to the armed forces. I want to say this is not a memorial to the armed forces. This is a memorial to the nation. It belongs to the nation. It doesn't belong to the armed forces headquarters. It perhaps doesn't even belong to the Ministry of Defense. It belongs to the country.
It belongs to the people of India, and the gentleman you see on your television screen, that's the Prime Minister of India. He's being welcomed by the three services chiefs. That's the Air Chief N.A.K. Brown, who's receiving him, the Defense Secretary after that. And it's these men who have to take the decision. The Prime Minister of India, the Defense Minister of India, the Government of India needs to decide. Now the Prime Minister will receive the Vice President of India, then the wives of the chief guests, and of course the escort of the President of India, and then the President of India himself will be escorted by the President's bodyguard. So that is how the ceremony starts. Just now, the Speaker of Lok Sabha, Meera Kumar, being greeted. Let's listen in to what's happening at Rajpath.
And other eminent persons. The first of the Rajpath bodyguard are all handpicked, all of them 64. Sorry, from the President on duty for the President. The officers and men of the bodyguard are three officers, qualified paratroopers and instant action. पहले गणतंत्र दिवस से ही मुख्य अतिथि को बुलाने की हमारी परंपरा रही है। आज के समारोह में भूटान नरेश हमारे मुख्य अतिथि हैं। कहते हैं खुशी बांटने से बढ़ती है। मेहमानों के साथ आज भी हम गौरवशाली पलों को साझा करेंगे। हमारी प्राचीन परंपरा भी तो है, अतिथि देवो भव।
The Prime Minister with the Defence Minister A.K. Antony there, the Raksha Rajya Mantri with him, the Chief of the Army Staff next to him. It's for these men now, Commodore Uday Bhaskar, to finally take a decision. In the 64th year of the Republic, we will have a national war memorial.
Well, I hope it happens, because I was just thinking, watching our Honourable Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh, that he has a very distinctive political record, which is that this is his 9th Republic Day, starting with 2005 January. And along with him, our Honorable Defense Minister, they represent one of the longest tenures where both of them have been in these high offices. And I do hope that before the UPA 2 completes its tenure, that this issue will receive appropriate notice. And I think, as General Prasad has just pointed out, this is not really a demand or something that the armed forces or the military are seeking. It is the symbolism for the nation, as I said, for the collective. And considering that India is the largest democracy in the world, it is a void that the national capital should still carry out all its ceremonial events at a structure that has a colonial linkage, which is World War I. And the Afghan wars. I mean, not for a minute is one in any way casting aspersions on the gallantry and the professionalism of the Indian Jawan, whether it was World War I or World War II. But it is the symbolism, and I hope UPA 2 takes it up in the CCS at the appropriate moment.
And quickly at that, that's the president's bodyguard, resplendent on their strides in their impressive uniform. Let's listen in.
Swagatam.
This is the arrival of Her Majesty Ashi Jetsun Pema, who is the Queen of Bhutan. Escorted by 46 bodyguards on magnificent bay-colored mounts, this is the President of India, Shri Pranab Mukherjee. Raised in 1773, the President's Bodyguards is the oldest and senior most regiment of the Indian Army. On the right of the President's cars is the Commandant of the regiment, Colonel Tejveer Singh Mundi, on his mount Virat. And on the left, the second in command of the regiment, Major Amit Bhardwaj, on his charger, Kran. The President is accompanied by our chief guest for today's parade, His Majesty Jigme Khesar Namgyal Wangchuck, the reigning King of Bhutan. The President of India, Shri Pranab Mukherjee, at the saluting base, and the nation welcomes His Majesty Jigme Khesar Namgyal Wangchuck, the reigning King of Bhutan.
The President's chief guests are received by the Prime Minister, Dr. Manmohan Singh. The Prime Minister introduces the National Jubilee campaign to the President and the chief guest.
Prime Minister introduces the chief guest to the dignitaries here at the saluting base.
Chief of Naval Staff, Admiral Sir Richard Doherty, Chief of Air Staff, Air Chief Marshal David Brown,
and another day of strengthening ties between India and Bhutan.
Having attended high school in the United States, His Majesty the King of Bhutan did his undergraduation and ethical informatics from Oxford University. With formal coronation on 6 November 2008,
महामहिम राष्ट्रपति प्रणब मुखर्जी के साथ हैं। 64वें गणतंत्र दिवस समारोह के मुख्य अतिथि भूटान नरेश जिग्मे गेसर नामग्याल वांगचुक। भूटान नरेश विश्व के सबसे युवा नरेश हैं और भारत के साथ गहरी मित्रता के सूत्र में बंधे हैं। दोनों देशों के बीच गहरे सांस्कृतिक संबंध है। राजपथ पर कुछ ही देर बाद भव्य परेड में देश की प्रगति और शौर्य के दर्शन होंगे। हमारी समृद्ध संस्कृति के रंग बिखरेंगे। महामहिम राष्ट्रपति को राष्ट्रीय सलामी और 21 तोपों की सलामी दी जाएगी। आन बान शान के साथ जनगण मन का सम्मान।
राष्ट्रीय रक्षा समित संघ राष्ट्र